The Gunnel Grabbers of Michigan went on their 12th annual canoeing trip this year to Northern Ontario. To meet the challenge of the Goat River, one of the many rivers in the James Bay watershed. The trip traditionally starts at Cliff Buckmaster's house, and though Cliff did not join us this year, we still gathered at his place for a little pre-trip horseplay, last-minute equipment repairs. Then on the road, over the bridge, and to Wawa, where we stayed at the Wawa Motor Inn, as we have always done in the past. We traveled this year with a group of 12, 6 canoes, 3 cars, and a well-loaded trailer. Going from Wawa to Hearst, we stopped at a midway point and had a roadside picnic at Lake Nagagamissis. Then on into the Queen's Motel in Hearst, where we spent Saturday night. On Sunday morning, we loaded our canoes and gear on the Algoma Central for the first big leg to our departure point on Lake Minnepuka. There were 2 other canoe groups on the train, so we shared stories and compared past experiences during the wait and on the trip to Oba. At beautiful Oba, we had a 4-hour layover, so we set up a breakfast cookout. Next to the station, we had pancakes and bacon, and then we were entertained by Scotty as we leisurely waited for the Canadian National. The Canadian National trip was only a very short run. In the water, down Lake Minnepuka to our first campsite. A beautiful spot with good tent sites, good fishing. The weather was overcast but cool and dry. We had a nice evening of fishing and relaxation. We checked our maps and then proceeded the next day through the Narrows and then into Goat Lake. One small rapids had to be portaged. In the bottom of these rapids was a beautiful deep pond surrounded by rock cliffs. The pond produced a few walleyes and was also the scene where Bud fell in. The rains had started that morning, and as you can see, the rain gear came out. Indigo Lake, where a small cabin was found and taken over by the group. It had rained all day, so the warm stove was welcome. Our group split and half slept outside in the tents and the rest in the cabin. We had only had a very short day on the lake before we came across this cabin, so we had most of the afternoon and a long evening. Some fished, some played cards. The offshore waters were fished very successfully by Barry and Joe and Sheldon. The following day, we proceeded on down Goat Lake in heavily overcast weather. Our first rapids were encountered, which Bud and Tom took successfully, and all the others portaged. It was below this area that the low water began to give us trouble. All the canoes got hung up at one time or other, but the two Grumman canoes with their keels were the most difficult to get over the rock beds. There was a lot of short portages, dragging canoes around the log jams and through the shallows. Several times we kept the canoes loaded and used a four-man carry. More rapids, most of which had to be run like a ski slalom course. Here Bob and Mike were doing great through a stretch of white water until an unseen rock brought them to a quick halt, which was a very common occurrence for all of us. Sheldon and Jung hung their canoe up quite often because of the keel construction. Here they demonstrate a well-executed 360. Al and Mike shooting a short stretch, and then Barry and Joe doing double cadence over the same water. Our third campsite was at the head of a series of rapids. This was a campsite with calm waters above and a cascading falls below. It's quite a beautiful spot. Al and Tom treated the group to Eggs Benedict that morning, and it's quite a welcome treat. Before heading downstream, we organized our group picture with a background of stacked canoes. Another fine portrait for posterity, and certainly no quiche eaters in this group. Back in the river and stretch of calm water, which we leisurely paddled through a beautiful spruce and cedar forest. Some more white water, and then our fourth campsite in a beautiful pine grove, very similar to the previous night. Downstream, we encountered a long, narrow canyon where the river narrowed down to around 6 feet. Bob and Mike led the way by running the stretch, followed by Barry and Joe and Bud and Tom. Here's Barry and Joe with their double cadence again. Thank you. The rains have been intermittent all morning, so a lunch stop with hot soup was welcomed by all. And a short distance downstream from here was a beautiful waterfall, which we portaged around. After which Ron experimented in the eddies of the falls with the one-man paddle. More shallow rapids with Jim standing in the middle of the stream pointing the direction. From the Goat, we canoed into the Matachewan on Thursday with our campsite located in the middle of the river on a rock island. And then on Friday, we encountered two areas which were a combination of portage and lining. It was a very time-consuming and very physically difficult operation. Downstream further and into the Missinabe at the Albany Rapids. Another shelf in the Missinabe River with churning white water. John and Ron got through. Mike and Al got through. Here we see John Gunnel grabbing. And Barry wanted to test the temperature of the water and show the depth. Which was followed by a dry out time and a warming time. Downstream a little further, we had to line around the Beaver Rapids and then even further, we had to do some more very tricky lining around Sharp Rock. And then a final run into beautiful glassy falls. For some of us, this is the fourth time camping at this beautiful site. Unfortunately, spoil more each year with beer bottles and camp litter. Final 3 hour run to Matthijs with Ron and Jim leading the way, followed by Sheldon and John, Bud and Tom, Barry and Joe, Al and Mike, and Bob and Mike. Into Matthijs, load up, and on our way back to Petoskey as we had another year of experience and another 100 miles of wilderness canoeing.